I understand Hinduism is a very pluralistic religion. I remember hearing Gandhi say, I'm a Hindu, I'm a Jew, I'm a Christian, I'm a Muslim. But I also understand that there is a rise of something very new in Hinduism, fundamentalists, that believe that their way is the only way and anyone else is not right. Could you explain, where does this fundamentalism come from? Is this really Hinduism? And what is the solution? Thank you.
I asked for a pointed question, you give me two pointed questions straight away. First of all, let us look at the history of the Hindus in general, just general comment. When you look at the history of humanity, the only nation that has welcomed people from other religion and allowed them to integrate and stay with them without conversion, without any pressure, without any taxation, only nation in the world that has allowed people of other religions to come and exist within them without any imposition is Hindus, I'm telling you. Let me give you the history. You can have a blip. Let me give you the total history. See the overall situation. The ancient Christian Syrians were persecuted. It's nothing new now. They were persecuted. Where did they find their home? In India. They're still there, allowed to practice their religion without any imposition, without any attempt to convert or tax them. The ancient Jews were struggling when the temple was destroyed. A lot of them ended up in India, and they still live there as Yahudis. And they practice their religion with full flow, no problem. What about the Baha'is? Where's the largest Baha'i temple? Again, India said, come, build it here. What about the most important, the Zoroastrian religion, the more ancient religion than even the Hebrew religion, the Parsis. The first religion in the Middle East was not Hebrew, not Judaism, it was Zoroastrianism. These lovely people, they are lovely people, were persecuted, they were going to be murdered or converted. And shiploads of them left Persia, ancient Persia, arrived in India, Gujarat, near Surat. And they have become part of the Indian community, Parsis. They eat Gujarati food, speak better Gujarati than I do, with tremendous humor. And they have been major philanthropic contributors toward India today. Major contributors, a small population, like the Tatas, they are Zoroastrian. And when I go to an interfaith meeting, I go to many interfaith meetings, if it's a Zoroastrian, he'll stand with Mr. Lakhani, do you know why I'm still a Zoroastrian? Because of you, you allowed us to exist, continue to exist as a religion. So they have got home in India. Where did the Dalai Lama live?
India.
Not China, not Tibet, India. So we have a very positive track record about linking with people of other religion as well as no religion. We never vilified them, we allowed them to stay with us. But what is happening now? This is what the gentleman is asking. Look, actually, that nation has stayed together as a single civilization over 5,000 years because it focused on higher principles, not material gains, not to conquer other people or pillage other people. Higher principles were the aim of that nation. Because it was focusing on higher ideals, it has stayed together as a single civilization over 5,000 years. The aim was always spiritual, not secular, not material. And then what did we do? We said, oh, we must follow the Western example. We must become secular. Sounds so good, but the secularism is so immature, it's frightening. So they kicked out spirituality and brought in secularism. Do you know how bad it is? Just give an example. I can teach Hinduism at every school in the United Kingdom, and I teach at Eton College. Happily, they welcome me, they embrace me, they pay me even. I can't teach Hinduism to a single Indian government school. You know that? This is this Indian secularism. They threw religion out of the system. And then you get all this corruption, all these guys filling their pocket. The whole system collapsed. Because the aim of the religion was always spirituality. And they threw it out, and the nation collapsed. That's why corruption is the name of the game in India today. Because the central feature of the religion, which was focusing on values and morality, thrown out. So what is happening now with this modern kind of political movement? Look, I'm not a politician. I'm not here to promote one individual or a political party. But I'm simply saying, that nation is stirring up, saying that the model that we adopted of secularism does not agree with our constitution, our makeup. We need a spiritual model rather than a secular model. And this is what is happening. This is the stirring that we see. And I welcome it, not because I'm welcoming people being, beaten up or something. That's the last thing the Hindus want to do, beat up or hit people of other religion. Or we've never done it. That's not in our system. We are pluralist through and through. But you will have blips, my friend, you will have blips. You will have some fanatic element, but that is available in every society, everywhere, including UK. You will have blips. But look at the overall, if you like, overall kind of history of how Hindus interact with people of other religion as well as no religion. It is very positive. But the good thing is, I like the stirring that I've seen more in India. This idea of spitting out secularism and adopting spiritual ideals. Hopefully, I told Narendra Modi's government, bring Hinduism back in the syllabus in schools. You've thrown it out. How dare you? Put it back. And do you know what is the problem? He can't get it done, even though if he wants to, because there's so much opposition, that what's the so-called secular forces would allow him. But this is the world that we face today. Well, it'll come through.